coach, just first impressions, Auburn, UCLA, Florida State, what was going through your mind when you saw that this morning?
Yeah, awesome. Obviously, we wanted to be within drive distance, be close. You know, we thought maybe Hattiesburg or Auburn were going to be the two. And obviously, when we saw Southern Miss come across the board and they had Army as the four seed, we knew pretty much we were probably going to Auburn. So, excited. You know, obviously, we've played Arkansas, Ole Miss, LSU this year. Nothing new there with the SEC stuff. And neat ballpark, neat college town to go into. And then when you add the 2 and 3 seed in Florida State and UCLA, historic programs like that that have so much tradition and, you know, some of the best programs in the country. Year in, year out, just an awesome feel for us and great opportunity for us to go prove ourselves.
You mentioned the games at LSU, Arkansas. How does playing in those kind of atmospheres during the regular season prepare you for what you're going to see this weekend?
Yeah, I mean, that's why we do it, right? I mean, you know, 2015 I go back to and we had 42 wins and didn't get the at-large bid. So then we vouched after that to also do what we can schedule-wise. I mean, it's probably one of the toughest things, nature of the beast, when you're trying to do scheduling to figure out who, where, when, how. Obviously, they've got, you know, schematics that are trying to be set up with RPI and home games and away games. So, you know, when we made this schedule, we felt really good about our club and where we were going to be from a talent standpoint and ability standpoint. Obviously, that changed pretty quickly there early in the season for us, but it definitely gave us the opportunities we needed to be to this point. Adam Guth isn't Adam Guth unless he's pitching against Ole Miss in a Tuesday game when they're ranked number one in the country. So, again, I think all that prepped us for now, and that was the idea, right, not to just get here, but to get here and make some noise. And playing the schedule we did, playing those teams, gives us that opportunity here this weekend.
Yeah, and you mentioned the start to the season. This team seems to play its best baseball when its back's against the wall, right?
Yeah.
And in these elimination games, especially over the last couple weekends, how have you kind of created that mindset in your team?
You know, I think what they've done a really good job of is staying in the moment. We continue to talk about that. We probably 2 or 3 months ago when it got dark, right? We had that 9-game losing streak. We talked about just win the moment. You know, if you win the moment, you got opportunity to win the day. So identify those moments, win those moments, and continue to move on from there. And, you know, again, I think they've encumbered that mindset in the same sense as when we lost that, you know, game one against Corpus Christi in the pod here. Hey, man, if we want to look at trying to go win 4 in a row and then go to, you know, Lake Charles the next weekend and win another 2 and 6 games, you start to complicate some things. You get too far ahead of yourself. So, hey, man, look at this as the beginning of the journey, not the end of the journey, right? Now that your back is against the wall and this could be the end, this is the beginning of a run we can make and then also continue to ride the momentum.
How much toughness does that give a team? Because I guarantee you there's no other team in the country that survives 6 elimination games.
Yeah. I mean, it's this group. I mean, again, I credit everything to our leadership, man. Our leadership is we've got some really good clubs in here. We've got some really good players in here. We've got some really good leaders in here. But collectively as a whole, this senior group, this upperclassman group, what they've shown in their leadership, man, the way they've been tested above and beyond any other club I've ever been around as a player or as a coach, man, and they continue to answer the bell. The toughness is the part of it, right? That is exactly why they're in this position. But we talked about at the beginning of the season, you know, if they were the most selfless team on the field, the most mentally tough team on the field, that they would be rewarded at the end.
And offensively, it seems like you guys picked it up a lot in the Southland Conference Tournament. What really clicked for you guys?
You know, that offense early in the season was obviously, you know, atrocious. I mean, obviously it didn't help the fact that we were playing at Arkansas and facing those arms and, you know, doing some things that didn't get us off to a great start. But in the same sense that I say that, we started to get some things going offensively. But our pitching, man, we were looking up and we were behind 6-7, 8-0. And, you know, again, I think it's an offense for us that, you know, we're going to continue to chip away at you. And then we're going to throw the big blow, right? We're going to continue to smother you until that release valve finally blows out, and then you get flooded with our offense and start scoring a ton of runs. And so I think they've stayed persistent at that point. Our pitching obviously has got it figured out a little bit since halfway through the season. Has kept us in ball games where we need to be kept in ball games. Have thrown up the zeros after we've scored runs and allowed our offense to continue to go and do what it's done. So obviously that rolled over into the tournament, man. You know, there were some guys that were a little upset after the Thursday night game that we got beat by Corpus. I mean, Corpus was a good offense, and we felt like if we held them to 6 runs, that should be a win. We get beat here at Hammond. You know, we lose the premier game on Friday night because of that first game one loss. The offense, you know, kind of took it upon themselves and accountability upon themselves that it was they're the reason we were in the position to be in loser's bracket. So they knew if we were going to win it, you know, making the run that we needed to make there in the back half of that pod, they were going to have to pick it up. And obviously they did that, man. To score what they did against, you know, HBU and UNO and all those guys, man, just a tremendous effort. And Preston Faulkner and Shea Thomas are two of the hottest hitters in the country right now, what they're doing.
What makes Preston such a special hitter?
You know, again, man, it goes back to his leadership. I think he is, obviously he's a great player. 5 years in our program, but What that young man is as a human being is even more special. He's been a rock for us. You know, again, when people have continued to tear this thing down and continue to break them down, and he's done a good job of being that voice for us internally to keep us together, to keep the glue together, keep us moving forward. And obviously then his play on the field obviously backs that up.
Where has he improved the most as a hitter?
You know, I mean, just his whole approach. His approach on the game, man, you know, we knew coming in when we recruited him that he was a guy who could hit for average and hit for power. Hit for power early in the career, right? We blended the approach together there at the back end, and a lot of things have clicked for him, man. Coach Pemberton, our hitting coach, man, has done a fantastic job with our offense, man. He's just done a really good job of being resilient and what he's trying to do from an approach and plan standpoint. Put those guys in position to be successful. So Puma's understood that, hey, man, when they groove one in there, hit the long ball, right? If they're only going to give you a backside single with two strikes, take your backside single. And know the moments that you got to win. If you got to take a walk, take a walk, because you got Shea Thomas right behind you.
Previously, you said that you were more confident in this group at 10-18 than you were with teams that were 18-10.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Again, back to our leadership, man. When we sat down in that conversation and that individual asked me that question, I knew what we had. I knew what we had endured. I knew the challenges that we were facing, and they never made an excuse, never made it the reason why they were failing. They started to encumber a different mindset of, this is going to be the reason why we succeed, man. To see that guy go down, that hurt, man. That hurt their, as a teammate. And so they kind of put it upon their own shoulders. Hey, man, we're going to overcome this for them, not be the reason that we don't, you know, have success.
And what was it like to win in Lake Charles, a place where you guys got swept previously,
yeah,
and they dogpiled on y'all's field?
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. Not one thought went through my head after we made that last out of, oh, hey, man, we did in Lake Charles. We did it against McNeese, man. I was just so happy and so proud of the guys, man, that they deserved it, man. Everything they'd overcome all year long to for them to be able to be in that moment. What we had personally endured in the fall with the passing of Mamu, the hurricane for the community, what they were representing, the pride they were taking in. Not one sense that, it, you know, okay, we did it at McNeese, you know, type of deal. Coach Hill's done a fantastic job with that program, man. And I'll be honest with you, both of us are cut from the same cloth. I don't think you would expect anything different from that three-game set of what we did, man, because both teams really are competitors, man. And obviously gave, I think, you know, Southland Conference would have won from a presentation standpoint.
What was it about the Southland Conference Tournament with the bracket play and
yeah,
then obviously the series that you think that prepares yourself for this weekend?
Yeah, well, you know, I'll be honest with you, I wouldn't feel very confident going to Auburn Regional, going through what we did, the Hammond Pod, right, and all the arms we threw, how many games we had to play, right, how many days we had to. You know, I mean, that takes a toll on you, right? Now to have to reset that and go in a three-game set, going to McNeese, right, we're a little fresher, you know, offensively, the players, you know, position player-wise, the arms are a little fresher, right, and not having to be as taxed as much. There's a few guys we didn't even use this weekend that'll be fresh for the regional as well. So I just think the emotional roller coaster, having to come back through the loser's bracket, right, and playing five games in 3 days or whatever it was to win that tournament, and then also just going to a two out of three series this past weekend. Again, a lot of emotions, right, playing for a championship, but in a three-game set, it's just better up mentally and physically to go into a regional and have some success.
Was this your hardest year as a coach?
You know, it's my most rewarding year, is what I tell you. You know, again, for the first 2 minutes after that last out was made, I couldn't say a word because there were so many emotions going through of all the things they've been through. I've got a laundry list. You know, there'll be a press conference, I'm sure, where I'll lay it all out there because I do. I want people to understand the story that these guys have gone through. There's no other teams ever endured what they've had to endure. And it's set up. You know, there's a time, there's a date, there's a stamp of what we continue to go through. You know, holding guys in my arms that thought their career was over because they got injured. You know, watching our team have to, you know, do what they did in the fall and go and bury a dear friend and a coach and a mentor and a line for life in the fall. Just all those things that they've had to go through and endure, man, this is definitely the most rewarding year, for sure. Yeah, I mean, obviously, again, it's just the amount of pride they play with. They do it for each other, and they do it for the city of Hammond. Our fan base has been resilient and staying with us, right? They continue to believe in us, especially our faithful ones that have been here year in and year out, and that's helped persevere these guys, obviously, to the finish line to finish off that conference tournament and get us to this point in the regionals. So, again, it's just a sense of pride they want to play with that, you know, again, they're trying to make each other proud, but they're trying to make the people that stuck with them the whole time proud as well.